Hello everyone and welcome back to CLGTart channel. Last week I did ask a question that what tutorial you want me record next in my community tab, and based on the like for every answer, I decided to make a tutorial about staining false creasing in Medibang Paint Pro. So thank you Madiha Nadeem, I guess that's what your name pronounced right, for asking me that. And here is your tutorial. So here is two poses that I use as example for this video. I already have the video about the outline work that I made in my channel, so you can share it around it, and I will just talk about that one just a little bit and focus on coloring and how shading this one. Okay, so step one, of course you have to create the outline work, and the other work is not really hard and you think that's really easy. You just have to have the base sketch about the neck body like this one, and you just follow it, make it like a guy, and you just follow this one. And the second thing that you have to remember when you outline the clothes your body, that the gravity and the motion, that means the gravity also will affect to the clothes and create some creasing and folds. This one is example, like you can see that maybe the character here is wearing the skirt, okay, and because of the gravity it will pull down here, and that why the clothing here that will follow and wrap and hug around the leg of this character. And then from this point here it stops stretching this point and starting to pull away because of the gravity. So that's how it's created. And because this one is a tension point and the folds here starting to creating here, like this one, yep, like this, and you can see that how the skirt that will create the folds, this one here. It's really easy, right? The second thing that you have to remember about the motion, like if your character is turning around and create the motions like this one, so the gravity now is not affect anymore, but the motions that will affect to the folds of your clothes, like it's move around here and the skirts will flip up like this one, and it will create the folds like this. The folds now will show the audience the motions of your character, so that's why you have to create the folds that turn around and circle and curve like this one. And when I turn up the sketch, you can see that a feeling like your character is moving, okay? Another thing is that when you create the folds in here, you must remember some part that, like the joint in here that will create the folds and top lines around this one here. It will bunches up around here and create a lot of folds, but avoid to draw too much like this one. It will make like your clothes is kind of too old and not cleaning. Yep. And the last thing when you create the folds and creasing for your character clothes, and that also the important things when you starting to coloring that the material of your clothes, that you have to think about how thick it is and how thin, how is heavy, and is it really heavy kind of material like the sweater, or it's just really light and easy to flowing like the t-shirt, some silky, yeah, kind of like this, the fabric, yeah. And with that material in your mind, you will thinking about it will bouncing light much or not, and it will be thick, so it will create the shadow different to the thin one. Yeah, that's it. So if you see that it will be thick fabric, this will create, it's not like this one anymore, it will be round around this part here to create a feeling like it's really thick and it's not wrapped around the body, but it will increase the size around here a little bit. Yeah, it depends on this one, and maybe you can see as some fabric that the author, they will draw like this one to show how thick the fabric is like this one. Yep. So that's just the example about the outline, and I will focus now to the coloring. So I already create some examples in here that the pants with the loose, it's really loose, right? Not really fit and affected by gravity. And the second one, it kind of take that is kind of like a sweater. Yeah, that's it. So there is two ways for you to shadowing the clothes. I think okay, the outlines in here I put it first and then create another layer, that layer 6 in here, and it will be below the outline layer. Okay, you see here, so it won't be covered by the light. I will create a new layer in here, that's the layer 10, and choose clipping. Why I'm not use protect alpha, because when I use protect alpha, that will affect to the base layer, like the original one here. When I erase or changing something, it will affect this one. With clipping, that won't let that happen. Okay, I will just erase in that layer, and everything in the layer 6 is normal. Okay, so there is two ways. The first thing is that really easy, that you can see that in anime and some kind of comic, they always use this one, is cell shading style. And when you create the clothes, the shadow of the clothes, you will pick the color, the base color, this one, and choose the darker color for the shadow. Now you have to think about the light, okay, the short light, where is it? So I will create a top layers in here to make an example for you guys. So here is the light, and it will affect to around this part. So that means this part here will be shadow, okay? And for some pose in here, it will create double shadows in here, and it will following along the pose, like here and here. You will get used to and thinking about where it creates shadow when you study a lot. When I'm walking on the street and I stare at the stranger, some people think I'm creepy too, because I'm staring to the clothes and see how the poses work under the light, strong light or normal light. Okay, so after you thinking about the short here, a short of the light here, you will see that where the light will affect around this part and this part here, but the shadows will appear here. It's really easy, right? And now I'll go back to the clipping layers here. I will use this color and starting to pen on this one here. Just follow the line, the fold line here. Okay, now I will turn this layer night and use the bucket tool to fill this one really quick, right? Then I will just make it look sharp, use the transparent box in here. It work as the eraser to erase some part. I think the light should cast to and make it look great. Okay, like this. You already create the shadow really quick, right? With this style, it's really quick. And the next thing that you have to thinking, that the fabric here is kind of like thick, right? So I will use the airbrush here to create some effect that make it, hey, the audience think that is kind of thick. So I will increase, increase the around the fold lines in here and starting to draw like this one. I'm not just under this one, since it's kind of thick, so I will drag around here and a little bit here. Then erase it again for some part here. You can see that the difference when you use the light, the sharp line here, is give you the feeling that the fabric here is kind of thin, but for this one here is more thick and more loose around here. Okay, so that's it, the first style. Since shadowing like this one is really quick, it's really helpful for you guys and reduce a lot of time when you're creating a webtoon or comics with a lot of colors like this one, because you have to draw tons of paint, so that will really help you. But in case that you love the realistic one and you want to have create more impressions and thinking about lightning and make it more realistic, so there is the second style I will show you guys, that I will duplicate this layer to show you the different later. Okay, and create a new layers in here. The layer 12 choose clipping again and thinking about bouncing line. The bouncing lines in here that you have to thinking about the environment that your character is put on, like she's on around her the characters here in the water, around the water, so there will be the light effect to the water and bouncing to the clothes in here, and how the clothes in here will receive the bounce line. So I will choose the blues in here, and like it will be the bounce line, and I choose watercolor brush. The watercolor brush will give you the soft feeling, and it will mixing color and give a best effect for this one. So the bouncing light is around here, and I will create the feeling with this one, and I will pick the mixed color between the blue and the shadow color here to create the transparent color and starting to blending like this one. Okay, now you are done with this one, and you can see that the base coloring here, some part it look kind of sharp, and they don't want it because it gives me the feeling is not right for the material. So I use the airbrush to make it look soft around a bit around here. So some part here. And the next thing is highlight. So you want to give more feeling about realistic, you have to create a highlight for your character clothes. Like I will create a new layer in here and choose clipping again. This is layer 13 here. Why I have too much layer and separate them, because that will help me easier to fix them later. And okay, here the highlights that even that you standing in a normal light, like in the day, but you standing under the tree, it also have the highlight in your clothes. That just a little, but it's half. So depend on this one. So I will make an example for the normal light here. I will pick the base color in here and choose the lighter color and use airbrush. I love this one because that one will give me a soft feeling around here that will create the best effect for this clothes. And a little bit highlight around here. Just really, really light. Nice. Here, yep, that's way better. Yeah, but this one. Just follow along the clothes here and think about where's the tension part here. Then this should be the tension part to create this, and this will catch the light around here, this one. And same here, the tension part here is the knee, and that will should be have the light around here and affect to this one. If you think this one is too much, you can pick the mix color between the base color and the highlight here to fix and drag around this one a little bit here, and changing the look of this, and you can see how it's changing the look of the cloth. And now I will turn off and turn on, turn off and turn on. You see the difference between you have and didn't have the highlight. So I will create a new layer to make an example. You don't need to have to do this one. I just want to show you get a difference that when you're standing in the strong light, okay? So in the strong light here, you can just leave the normal light like this one, or you can create a new layer and start to the strong light too. That depends on your choice. My cat is jumping, so I will distract a little bit. Okay, so here I will create a strong light, and thinking about this one, you will create a strong light like your character is standing somewhere in the desert and that will be under the sun, so the sun that will affect to your clothes and create really, really strong light. It should be around that yellow and orange color here. And then I would use the watercolor brush. Why? Because the strong light here will give you the effect like this one. Yeah. And I'm starting to draw the strong line here. Okay, here now you are done the highlight. Here is the normal light and here is under the strong light. You can see that the line now here in this color will be the bothersome and look make it look not perfect. And in this case that I can drag it around here and choose lighten to make this effect to affect to the light in here. That depends your choice, that whatever you want to do. Okay, and that's it. I will show you the difference that what we doing here. That will be the base color, the cell shading style, and that really easy and quick to do. Okay, remember that the sharp one is in here for the thin material, and the soft around here will give you the feeling like it will be the thick material. And another thing is that you will have this one and you want to add the effect around the bouncing light for the environment, for the highlight and the strong light. You can do this one, stop the bouncing light if it's not have to, but I guess you should do this one if it gives you more feeling realistic. So that is all about this tutorial. I hope this one will help you, and here I will make some example for you guys. Have fun to watch this one.